Congratulations, Denise, on the book. If
thank
you.
Thank
you. Out tomorrow. Because I know last time we were speaking, you were just sort of finishing it and getting it all sorted.
Yes.
Now, this woman, this lady Harper, that's in here, how would you sum it up, do you think? Because I wanted to shake her sometimes.
Yeah, I know. I mean, basically, to sort of praise it, Harper is a woman in her 50s, and I had to fight for a publishing deal for a woman in her 50s, mm-hmm. You know?
Interesting.
And but she's very glamorous. She's very... she's quite affluent, and she's married to Aaron, and Aaron is it's very difficult without giving too much away, but basically there is an element of control.
Oh, just a bit
within the marriage, emotional control.
Exactly, that's what was really interesting, Denise, because he doesn't batter her, but no. He chips away at her confidence. Well, all
absolutely
the time.
I've had experience of that in the past, not to the extent of Harper.
Yeah,
but it was interesting. So basically the book generally is my observation on how the demographic in a marriage changes as the kids grow up and leave home.
Right.
And as an actress, I'm quite an acute observer, I suppose.
Yeah.
And I found that some people, you know, empty nest syndrome doesn't really happen. It's like, hooray, no more dirty washing, no more pizzas growing up the side of the wall. They're off and so are we. And that's one side of the spectrum. Yeah. The other is sitting facing your partner and thinking, because my thing is, life is not too short. Life is too long to be with you for maybe another 40 years. Mm. So it's whether or not you go. A generation ago, it was a case of hearing your mum or your granny's voice ringing in your ears saying, well, you've made your bed, you lie in it.
Yeah.
And people did.
Absolutely.
And now a lot of women, not all, but a lot of women have the financial independence to leave, but sometimes not the emotional strength to leave. And I met a couple who were in their 80s, and he has a photo of them on the sideboard. And everybody who comes in, he says to them, look what I married and look at her now. And honestly, and he's no oil painting himself,
no,
Lorraine, let me tell you,
no.
You know. And it was just the fact that even if she had wanted to leave, you could see that he had chipped away at her
absolutely
confidence.
Absolutely.
And so I want it to be aspirational. I also wanted it to include some passions of mine or things I'm passionately against, one of them being fat shaming.
Oh, because the daughter... The lovely daughter, who's a lovely girl.
Well, I
again, the dad's
so
horrible.
Well, I thought about using Harper as the vehicle for it, and then I thought, no. So I used Georgie, the 14-year-old daughter. You know, I have a 14-year-old myself. Obviously, you write about what you know. My career as a novelist, it's in its infancy, so I can only write about what I know. It's not autobiographical, but I have a 14-year-old son, and Georgie's 14. And how bullying doesn't just happen in school, hugely on social media. I know from having my own child and having gained access to the phone, it's just not a fun place to be.
It's actually quite scary.
It's really
quite
scary.
There's another life going on there.
There really is.
Which most parents don't know anything about.
To say to a teenager, you know, come off social media is like saying, I'm going to chop your right arm off while you're sleeping. You know, I mean, it's really difficult.
Yeah.
So you just, it's hard to monitor. Mm. But yes, Harper is also, Harper's daughter Georgie is also bullied within the home.
Yeah, as well as at school.
But it's passive aggressive bullying. So
the worst kind.
Absolutely. Yeah. And of course, eventually the decision has to be made is do you stay or do you go? So I wanted it to be, you know, it's not heavy and all about Denise's, you know, but it's also hopefully lots of fun at times.
Oh, no.
Like we said earlier, an easy read. I know when I'm reading, I'd like to say I have War and Peace by my bed, but I don't,
what's
Lorraine.
Your telly version?
I love a, you know, Susan Lewis or a Martina.
Yeah, you betcha, you know, Martina Cole.
And I like to be able to think, oh, I'm really looking forward to going to bed. If someone says, you've got to get through the first 100 pages, bye, not interested, can't be bothered, don't have the time. So I tried it on my girlfriends and they, you know, phoned at 2 a.m. and said, we're still reading it.
That's the test, and they would be honest. Which is fantastic. And as you said, you write about what you know. And you do write about the Northeast and the character's dad.
Well, she's based in the Northeast because when I'm writing about colour coats, that's where I'm from.
Yeah.
So I can envisage it.
Of course.
She lives in Cheshire. I know a lot about the Cheshire set. Yeah. I'm not immersed in it, but I think that most people who live in Cheshire will relate to some of them, or at least know some of the women I'm talking about.
And have watched the telly series, maybe.
And have watched the telly series, and I know a couple of girls in the telly series. So obviously I know that, and I wanted, you know, and as I say, the control is something, you know, a lot of women that I speak to.
Yeah.
It's actually quite fortuitous as well because, of course, the law is passed or being passed where emotional bullying within a marriage, emotional abuse, will be treated at long last on the same level as physical domestic abuse. You know, and the scars are just as difficult to
You can do another one.
I'm doing it now.
Are you doing it now?
I have a two-book deal, Loth.
Excellent.